So catch and shoot. Nice. Yep. Good. Hiya, my name's Glenn Holmes. I'm the co-owner of the Box and Burn Academy, the world's number one boxing fitness education course. I'm also the founding trainer here at Box and Burn in Los Angeles. Welcome to my YouTube channel. So the first way we can defend the straight right is by shooting the right hand at the same time, except shooting the right hand to the body. So if I'm trying to attack with my right hand, she can slip it, but as she slips, she throws that right hand to the body and then comes right back in to reset, okay? So as I go with the right shoulder, she sees it coming and just goes with the punch and counters the punch with a punch. Boom, slips over so the head's off the line, lands that right hand to the body. And if I'm committing to a right hand, I'm probably not expecting that punch to land at the same time as mine. I might expect the slip, so therefore I'd be like kind of committed to it, but I've expected the slip, but I might not have expected that punch. If I'm not expecting that punch to land, that's how that punch is gonna work and do damage, because I might be not as engaged in the abs as I should be. And when I'm committing to that punch, if I'm relaxed down there and that lands, boom, that could be a knockout shot, a straight right hand to the body. So the key with this, if you're defending and countering, is to kind of watch the shoulder and chest area. So she's right here and we're kind of engaging. As soon as she sees that right hand, that right shoulder start to go, she just goes automatic, just slips and throws the punch and just kind of takes a gamble in a sense, just to try and land that body shot as I throw my shots. Right here, she's seeing that right hand come in, boom. The right hand comes in at the same time, boom. And it'll land, the key is to land it slightly below that chest bone, right in the sternum, right there in that solar plexus area. Boom, and that's gonna take the wind out pretty quick if I'm not switched on for that shot coming in. So defending and countering the straight right with a punch at the same time and countering it to the body. So that's number one. In a minute, I'm gonna show you how to execute these on the mitts. Before we get to the second one, I just want to remind you, slip and counter that subscribe bell on YouTube, so that way you get notified of the videos each week. Subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions about any of this stuff, leave them in the comments below as well, and just hit like on the video too. All right, so the second way we can defend that right, if I'm just throwing that straight right hand, she's gonna use the front hand to parry it, right? So you can see that shoulder going. Her reaction is just to kind of deflect it, making sure this fist is tight and solid, and she's kind of knocking the glove down and away, which is pulling me off balance, right? Rather than a soft fist that just doesn't really do much and doesn't really discourage me from throwing that shot. And if that hand's loose, it could slide through the glove and land as well, right? So anytime you're parrying a shot, especially a power shot, the fist's gotta be real tight and you gotta be kind of aggressive with that parry to try and deflect it away, to pull me off balance. From there, we can counter. So she parries that right and it kind of pulls me in, right? So just parry and keep the glove up, boom. She knocks, keep that elbow down. She's gonna knock it, deflect it off to the side, right? So from there, I'm pulled into a position I don't wanna be in. Right uppercut to the body or to the chin right there is available. And she kind of leans back as she parries it. If she leans back, double reason to do that. Number one, it's safer, right? She's pulling her body away from it. And if that punch did get through, if she's leaning back, that's taking the sting out of the punch. Canelo, pound for pound number one right now, genius that even when he does get caught, the few times that he does get caught with a punch, you'll see he's turning away from the punch. He rolls the punches. So even if a punch lands, it's taking the sting out of the punch. So he's not going into the punch to create that momentum where it can do damage. So when you're parrying that straight right, you kind of lean back into that back leg a little bit. Not only is she taking the sting out of my punch if it did get through, but she's loading up the counter punch on that power side, loading up about 60% weight in the back foot, ready for a rear uppercut either to the chin or to the body would be an effective counter from there. All right, so there's the two ways you can counter the straight right hand. You can slip and throw the shot to the body. And then the second one, a classic parry, roll back with the shot and shoot the uppercut coming in, boom. Yeah, and then get the weight back through with the uppercut, boom. Yeah, right there. All right, so that's how, those are the concepts. That's how we're gonna defend that straight right. Stay tuned, I'm gonna show you exactly how to pull this off on the mitts. All right, so how do we pull this off on the mitts? So for the first one, as a coach, I'm just gonna throw a straight right. She's gonna slip it, but I'm gonna have that mitt ready right in the exact spot I want it. Like I said earlier in the video, right under that chest bone, right on the abs right here. And that way they can really land a solid straight right when you're catching this punch as well, as the coach, make sure you've got those abs nice and tight, especially if you're working with a heavier puncher. You don't want to discourage people from throwing with maximum power on this one. If you're uncomfortable, get them to start off nice and light. As you get more comfortable, you can build up the power as you go. But we're just bracing ourselves for that shot as we throw the cross. So I'm throwing the straight right, but my mitt's already in place. Ready? Go. Good. And then you can tell your boxer when you want to go. That way you can time it. Good. Go. Good. So once you've got that timing down, then we can start to build up those defensive reactions and just kind of be loose and moving and just throw it out of nowhere. Good. Which is training her now to watch that right shoulder and that right glove coming in, right? So she's ready. Shoot it right on the pad. Ready? Good. Good. And exhaling with the punch as well. Just shifting the head off the line, getting over to the left side. Good. So the weight's coming through to the left side as well when she throws that punch. Just throw it and hold. All that weight's loaded on that left side. That's getting more power in that punch as well. Ready? Nice. One more. Good. So there's number one. That's how we would execute and practice and drill that first slip and counter on the mitts. So for the second one, before I show you this one, I just want to remind you, hit subscribe on the channel. That way you're going to get notified on all the videos. Like this video, leave any questions or video requests in the comments below. All right, so number two, I'm throwing the straight right. As the coach, I'm going to throw it straight at her head, so keep it as realistic as possible. As it's coming in, she's going to parry it. I'm going to get the mitt back quick and leave her that target for the uppercut. So we're only using the right glove or the right mitt for this one. So again, it's just I'm throwing the right, she parries it with the front glove, and then boom, whips that uppercut in straight away. Now, we want to try and create a realistic situation where they're parrying and shooting quick. So as the coach, you've got to be prepared for that counter. Think ahead right here. So as soon as you feel that mitt being parried, get the mitt back in place for the uppercut. And this can be an uppercut to the head or to the body as well. So if you're just giving kind of a general target right here, that could either be here, or if it was somebody getting a bit closer, it could be right there in the ribs as well. Okay, so catch the cross, shoot the right uppercut. Good. Stay nice and low when you throw those uppercuts. And again, just like we did with the cross to the body, we're getting that weight back to the left side. So catch and shoot. Nice. Yep. Good. So I'm trying to be as fast as I can to make sure she can be explosive as well. So it's there, and then as soon as I feel that contact, boom, straight back and in place for the uppercut. One more time. Catch. Good. Again. There we go. Good. So there's two realistic ways you can defend that straight right. The straight right is the most, well, probably one of the most dangerous punches in boxing. So the better you can get at defending that punch, the better you're going to be as a boxer. If you can also work on countering it like we just did in this video, even better, you're on to a winner. Let me know if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Check out the other videos on the channel. Thanks for watching.